CO2 delivery devices. We'll be highlighting three of these devices. First, the nasal cannula, the non-rebreather, and the bag valve mask. Although there are other devices that you can use in order to deliver oxygen, so these are the three main types that will be used on the back of the ambulance. Let's first look at the nasal cannula. The nasal cannula is designed to provide low flow oxygen for a patient that is stable. The nasal cannula will increase oxygen percentage that is delivered from a room air concentration of 21% up to 24 to 40% depending on the flow rate that you're delivering through this device. Through the oxygen source, we can give a flow rate between 1 and 8 liters per minute. I will now connect it. In order to apply the nasal cannula, we first must take note of the directions of this small cannula, the two cannula ends here. These should be in a downward position as they go into the nares. So always starting from below the patient's head, we insert the cannulas in a downward position into the nares, come around the patient's ears, meeting below the chin, and pushing a little zip tie up to the bottom jaw. As with any oxygen delivery device, you never apply unless the oxygen is currently running. The second of our O2 delivery devices is a non-rebreather mask. Like the nasal cannula, this does increase oxygen percentages that are being delivered, but from 21% of room air, this will increase oxygen up above 90%. This increase in oxygen percentage is achieved by a higher flow rate delivered through a mask. In order to apply this to our patient, we first must allow oxygen to be delivered into the mask and into the reservoir chamber here. We must set this to a much higher rate than the nasal cannula. We typically run this from anywhere from 8 liters and above, but in general, 15 liters per minute is a typical standard setting for a non-rebreather mask. I will now allow oxygen to go into the mask. This is at 15 liters. Take our finger and place it over the small valve, which will allow the reservoir bag to be filled up. At this time, we can now apply the non-rebreather mask. As with the nasal cannula, all O2 delivery devices must be running before we place it on our patient. Be cautious with a non-rebreather mask. Make sure that the reservoir bag is always filled and oxygen is being delivered to the device. If the oxygen were to run out or if the O2 tubing was disconnected, our patient may suffocate as a result. The third and final of the O2 delivery devices we'll be discussing today is the bag valve mask. The bag valve mask is used for patients who need assistance in ventilation. Our patients may be apneic or have apneic respirations. At this point, we would use a delivery device that will actually breathe for our patient. Note the parts of the bag valve mask. Reservoir bag, the bag itself for ventilation, the mask. Sometimes we'll see pop-off valves or restriction devices that allow or control the rate of our breathing. The bag valve mask may be utilized with or without oxygen. Without oxygen is bringing in room air in order to ventilate our patient. This will only achieve 21% oxygen. but when an O2 source is attached, this can bring our O2 percentage up to around 100%. We'll use a flow rate through our regulator of at least 15 liters per minute for an average adult patient. We may utilize the bag valve mask with one or two rescuers. Similar to that of the pocket mask, the fitting is the same. The bridge of the nose will come to the upper portion here, and it will make a seal around the nose and the mouth. We'll be utilizing the EC technique, as seen here. C, E will be these three fingers here. It is very important when utilizing a back valve mask that we open the airway with a head tilt chin lift. We grab the jaw and lift in the upper position here, lifting upward. With each breath, lasting about a second to a second and a half, allowing the chest to rise and making sure that the patient has time to exhale before giving the next breath. Typically, ventilation should only occur every 5 to 6 seconds on the adult patient. 1-1000, 2-1000, 3-1000, 4-1000, 5-1000, 6-1000. A two rescuer technique may be utilized as well, where one rescuer will make the seal with two hands while the other one will ventilate.